When I first saw the first image from the movie that came out on Netflix already, I was like, wait, is this going to be some kind of generic kids jungle adventure movie? But then after when I watched this film, I was like, whoa, I have to admit, this was pretty good. But I'll explain everything I like from this movie in this review. Cue the intro.
All of my life, I thought I was right, looking for something new. Stuck in my ways, like old-fashioned days, but all the roads led me to you. The house that you live.
Hey guys, this is Trolls Hanna-Barbera Pixar Fanatic 2007 here, and guess what? I just watched Netflix/Braun's new animated movie, The Willoughbys, and I'll explain everything what I like from this film after when I tell the plot. So please enjoy. So the plot for The Willoughbys is the Willoughbys live in a strange house with their family, and their family didn't love their kids. And then suddenly, the Willoughbys decide to do something so they can be orphans. And then they put a travel agency to their parents, and then they leave through the house. And then suddenly, the Willoughbys are now orphans. And then suddenly, they meet a nanny, and then. They go on an adventure to find their parents back. And then suddenly, after when they found their parents stole their ship. Stole the Willoughby's floating thing or whatever it is. And then suddenly, I won't give any spoilers to the ending, so yeah. And you know what? That's basically what the plot is, guys. Now, to be honest, I have probably never read the book about the Willoughbys. I know this movie is based off by a children's book, but I have not read it. But then suddenly, back in like in late 2019, Netflix/Braun announced that there will be making a Willoughbys movie that is coming to Netflix. And I was like, what is that? And suddenly, after when I watched the trailer, I was like, I don't know, but I may give it a chance soon. But then suddenly I rewatch it. Now I've been looking forward to it. But now this is the day when it finally comes out on Netflix. And guess what? And what do I think of this film? I have to admit, this movie is really good, but really close to a masterpiece in my opinion. So yeah, now let's talk about the story. The story is really decent in my opinion. It's kind of a little teeny tiny bit similar to Finding Nemo's story, or I don't know. And the animation, let's talk about the animation. The animation, well, I have to admit, that animation was really interesting. It's like a mix of CGI and stop motion come together, and the animation probably kind of reminds me of that kids show that Eric Creel likes from his childhood, and that is Jelly Jam. Yeah. So, yeah. And let's talk about the characters. The characters were kind of good. Tim is really nice. He's voiced by Will Forte. I can't wait for Will Forte's role to play Shaggy when I see Scoob on Home on Demand on May 15th, which, stay tuned for my review on Scoob, it's gonna be a blast. And Jane is really, really good, and very cute. And I like the way she sings. She sings really perfect. and the Barnaby twins. The Barnaby twins were very funny. I really kind of very interest that those characters both named Barnaby. I really did not know that. The nanny is really funny, and Melonuffs has to be my second favorite character of this movie. He's really great, and he's the worker of his own candy factory. And Ruth, the baby, he or she is kind of cute. So yeah, she or he is kind of cute. He's really cute. So yeah. Now after I talk about the characters, now I'll talk about the writing. The writing was really good and decent. And the music is really, really feeling good and really interesting. I really like Jane's song, by the way. Sorry if I stuttered a lot, so yeah. I don't know how many times I say so, yeah, guys. The backgrounds and the designs of the characters and everything they put on this movie, they really kind of interest me. And the character designs kind of reminds me of the Addams Family mixed with Despicable Me. Which, I don't know, so yeah. And I will not give away any spoilers from this movie. I will not give spoilers, so yeah. And finally, let's talk about my favorite scene of this film. My favorite scene of this film is the scene where Ruth eats all the candy in Melonuff's candy factory. And that scene really laughed me out. And then suddenly, after when Ruth eats all the candy, he threw up. His vomit was like full of rainbows. That kind of reminds me of that gnome throwing up during the end credits scene of an episode from Gravity Falls. Well, overall, guys, I like this film. It's good, but very, very close to a masterpiece. It's good, but I think Klaus is a far superior Netflix movie than The Willoughbys. Which, I still kind of enjoy The Willoughbys, but I think Klaus is a far superior film in my opinion. Please, Tails, respect my opinion on Klaus. Anyways, guys, so, on a scale, 1 out of 10 stars, I'm going to give The Willoughbys an 8 out of 10. I really have to say, it's kind of worth watching, in my opinion. But I'm not going to give this film the seal of epicness and rainbows, guys. Well, thanks for watching this review. If you want to see more movie reviews, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell to see more videos from me. So, yeah. And since when I heard this news back in yesterday about the Scoob 2020 that is coming to Home on Demand, my next movie I'm going to see is... Yep, you heard me 5 seconds ago, Scoob. I'm definitely hyped for this movie. It's gonna be one of the best movies based off by a Hanna-Barbera cartoon. And it's gonna be even better than the Yogi Bear live-action movie. So yeah, so stay tuned for my review on this one. And in fact, what are your thoughts of The Willoughbys? Do you liked it, or really loved it, or you thought it was meh, or you disliked it, or you just hated it, or think it's bland? So yeah. If you don't liked it, I respect your opinion, but please don't take my opinion way too seriously, so yeah. So thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you guys later!